to the fifth session of the CrackIt 2021 pre-placement program. It is great to see new members joining this group each day. It gives us a feedback that we started off this program on the right foot. On behalf of the students, I would like to thank the CET Alumni Association and its members for their constant support and cooperation. We are extremely grateful to you for the successful implementation of this training. We believe and hope this course will provide the students with essential tips needed to crack placements. Now, I invite Akshay M. to deliver the welcome speech. Akshay, over to you.
Hey guys, it is by ardent hard work and indomitable will that every dreams are achieved. It takes more than just commitment. It takes sheer will and a lucid plan to work it out. To prove our mettle, we shall first make it the will ourselves strong. It is by rigorous and persistent work without fatigue, which makes everything dreams inevitable. On this auspicious occasion, we have the privilege to learn and imbibe from an eminent personality. I welcome Mr. Krishnakumar K., one amongst our finest alumnus, senior Toastmaster, former managing director of Zoomlex Business Group, member of various professional and social organizations, and more. It is our pleasure to have you as a sir, Dr. Anjan R. Nair, Dr. Jayashree, and our alumni, Sadir sir, Advocate Murugesh sir, Riju sir, and Priya ma'am for the event. Finally, this program couldn't be more meaningful if it weren't for you guys, who are the promise of the future. I welcome all the participants of the CrackIt 21 and expect their coordination and support. Thank you.
Thank you, Akshay. You must have heard the quote, "You never get a second chance to make a great first impression." Well, the topic of today's session is first impression and etiquette. I would like to introduce our guest lecturer for today's session, Mr. Krishnakumar K., Senior Toastmaster and former Managing Director of Zoomlex Business Group. Let me give you an introduction about him. It gives immense pleasure to know that Mr. Krishnakumar K. is CET alumni who completed his mechanical engineering studies in 1977. For over 30 years, he worked all over Middle East and parts of Africa. He worked as the managing director of Zoomlex Business Group. He's an avid traveler and a senior Toastmaster. He's also a member of several other professional and social organizations and has spoken at international seminars. Personally speaking, I've got the opportunity to listen him speak during the sessions held by CET Communication Club. Being a person who is extremely passionate about fitness and healthy living, Mr. Krishnakumar K., alias KK, is now retired and currently stays at Trivandrum. Sir, we welcome you. You may please take over the stage.
Thank you. Thank you very much for that exemplary introduction, Aksa. The subject today is first impressions and etiquette. Like you said, you never get a second chance to make a first impression. That itself says a lot. Now, what is first impression? First impression is the mental image that you form when you meet another person for the very first time. Now, there is a saying, do not judge a book by its cover. But sadly, this is what happens in normal life. Within the first 10 seconds of meeting a person, our mind forms an impression about that person. Right or wrong, this impression stays in the person's mind for a long time. Now, therefore, it is crucial that when we go into a meeting, whether to meet a client or whether to meet in a social gathering, whether to meet someone, and more important, if you are meeting an interviewer, that you utilize the first few minutes to create a very good impression on the interviewer. Why is this important? Because an impression once created is very difficult to change. it's difficult to change the first impression. You can improve upon it as the discussion progresses, but you will never be able to change it. Now, first impression and followed by etiquette. There are etiquette is a set of rules or norms by which you are expected to behave at an event, whether it's a formal meeting with a business meeting or whether it is a social get together. Even if you are attending a wedding, there is a certain etiquette which you are supposed to follow. Now, today we are here to discuss first impression and etiquette with specific reference to interviews, job interviews. Now, we will examine several tips and do's and don'ts that matter in creating a good first impression and the kind of etiquette one is expected to follow if you are to make a good impression. Now, I would like to share the screen because I have made a PowerPoint presentation. Let's see whether it works. Yeah. Well, in a normal face-to-face interview, I will come to the virtual interview later. In a normal face-to-face interview, when the candidate walks into the interviewer's office, he has to follow certain very clear norms. First, he has to look positive and confident. Don't go drooping like this, you know, tired and all that. You have to be very confident in your face. You have to stand tall. Whether you are tall or not, you have to appear tall. This is very important. And the second thing is the dress. Now, you don't have to be dressed like a model, no. But the dress has to be appropriate for the occasion. Now, normally in a business interview, you wear formal clothes, and in some organizations, formal clothes are not required. It is like smart casual. These days with IT firms, many people prefer smart casual. I will come to dressing later, but the first thing is, as you enter the room, you have 10 seconds to make the interviewer comfortable. Have a smile on your face, not a laugh, but a smile, a gentle smile, you know, a welcoming smile. And then be open and go across to shake hands. And while shaking hands, if you know the name of the person, you say, "Good morning, sir. I'm very pleased to be here. Thank you for the opportunity to meet you." Something like that you can say. But you have to rehearse whatever you're saying so that you don't make a mistake. Usually it is, "Good morning, sir. I'm pleased to be here." That is adequate. Now, if you know the name of the person, then you can say, "Good morning, Mr. John. I am pleased to be here." So this is the way you start off. Then if there are multiple people, if there are three people on the board, you can say, "Good morning, gentlemen. I'm very happy to be here." And then go ahead and shake hands with each of the three people, depending on the way the table is laid and the way they want you to sit. As you shake hands, make sure you look into the eyes of the person that you're shaking hands. That shows confidence. That shows that you are not a shy person. That shows that you're not hiding anything. So this is the kind of confidence that should exude from you as you shake hands. For all this to happen, it is very important to arrive at the interview venue a little early. Sometimes you are in a city that you are not familiar with. You may be called for an interview in Bangalore or Madras, and they say the office is on Mount Road. You think you know Mount Road, but you don't know the exact location. You don't know if you are going in your own vehicle, whether you get a parking space. So all these are challenges which you need to think in advance. If I were going, I would go there the previous day and have a look at the exact location, the road, the traffic conditions and everything, because the worst thing that you can do is to turn up at an interview late and having to apologize. Because if you walk into an interview room apologizing, then your score is already love 15 in tennis terms. So you don't want to be a love 15. You have to be 15 love as you enter. In the first 7 to 10 seconds, the interviewers should say, here is a confident guy. He looks good. He is fine. I hope he will satisfy us. So this is the thinking that you should be able to convey. So shaking hands, arriving on time. Now, another thing, when you arrive on time, if there is a receptionist in the office, make sure that you talk very courteously to the receptionist. Not personal details, nothing very personal, but say, "Good morning, miss. You know, I am here. I am Krishna Kumar. I've got an interview at 10 o'clock. I just came a little early. At 9:55, you can inform them that I'm here." Because again, you don't want to be too early. Maybe the interviewer is finishing on some important work before the 10 o'clock time, and you are landing up at 9 a.m. or 9:15 and saying you are come at an interview. That guy will think this fellow is a joke. He has no other work. He's coming early morning and sitting here. And that might put a little bit of pressure on the interviewer psychologically. And he may not want you to wait. So he may try to rush. And in the back of his mind, he'll saying, "This stupid fellow, he has come so early morning and I spoil my morning. I have to finish all these things." So that you should avoid. Arrive early. If necessary, go to the restroom. Comb your hair. Look good, you know, if you are sweating, because normally when you go for your first interview, however brilliant you may be, you are still a little bit tense. When you are tense, you may be sweating. Maybe you took an auto to the work and there were a lot of dust and fumes on the road. You want to freshen up. So you can ask a receptionist, "Can I use your restroom?" And most big companies have proper restrooms. You can use, wash your face, have a sip of water, and then 5 minutes before your appointed time, you should inform the interviewer that you are here for the interview. So this is the first part. If we get through this, and if you go into the interviewer's room, look tall, look confident, shake the hands of the interviewer. If you know his name, say that, and then they will ask you to sit down. Sit down. Don't sit down like this, relaxing, as if you are watching a movie. Sit straight. Don't cross your legs, because you have some people sitting, they cross the legs. That is not allowed. You sit straight with both feet firmly on the ground, and then don't cross your hands like, don't cross your hands like this. Don't put your hands in the pocket. Keep your palms open and just take a deep breath and wait for the first response from the interviewer. When you are applying for your first job, you don't start talking pleasantries with the interviewer, because the interviewer may be at a much higher level than you. But if you're going for the second or third job, suppose you're applying for a sales manager's position and you have 10 years experience, then you can talk about IPL, what happened the previous day. You can say, "Yeah, I was, you know, I hope you are supporting Chennai Super Kings. It was a fantastic match." Something like that to break the ice. You can have some sort of small talk. But in a first time interview, where especially campus recruitment, you are not expected to engage in small talk. Besides, this interviewer may be interviewing 50 to 60 people the same day. So he really does not have too much time to evaluate you. The maximum you are going to get is between 20 and 30 minutes if you are lucky. So this is very, very important. This is very, very important to have in mind, that not to not to upset the interviewer. Now, again, you should understand and always bear in mind that you are in someone else's territory. It is not your office. It is not your college. You are walking into a room which is controlled by the interviewer. So he has control over the space. He has control over the time. So you have to always have that in mind. You don't come in and look everywhere and say, ah, it's fine. Nice room. So you don't appear too over-friendly to the interview team. You can make a small comment if you want, but normally that's not expected in the first job or in a campus selection. If they ask you something, you have to reply. Then I believe there are further sessions on how to prepare for the interview. Am I right, Satish? So I will not go into the details of how to actually respond to questions, but I must mention that there are so many questions that the interviewer may ask, and you have to have a very clear response. You have to practice. Common questions include, tell me something about yourself. Now, will you talk about your family? Will you talk about your love for cinema? Will you talk about something else? You have to talk about what is relevant. What is relevant in your CV, what is relevant to the particular job position that is advertised. So, when you go for an interview, it is always important to carry a copy of your CV with you, preferably two copies, because sometimes the interviewer may not have a hard copy in front of him and he may ask you, and at that time, you should be ready to give a copy of the CV. Just before the interview, before you go for the interview, please also read your CV and please read the job description for which you are attending the interview. Because as a graduate engineer, you may apply for multiple jobs. You don't want to be preparing for one job description while attending the interview for another job. They may be wanting a web designer, and you may have applied for software engineer. So that also is very, very important. So when I ask you, tell me about yourself, you have to mention few things in there that will make the interviewer interested in your CV. Remember, the first interview is not to get the job. It is to get a second interview. It is for getting into the short list. So don't give out your entire history there. Answer to the point and maybe 10% extra. Don't use all the time to answer one question, because there are other questions coming. Now, I am deviating from the subject here. Let me come back to the handshake. Now, there are various types of handshake. First is a handshake which is the bone-breaking handshake. This is if you have a chance to shake hands with the army colonel or brigadier, you will experience this. He will crush your palm. You will regret that you ever shook hands with this person. So don't do that. But at the same time, be very firm. Your hand should be like this. Be very firm. You should clasp it. And the web of the hand should touch the web of the interviewer. So that is you should have the hand full, not like this. There are some people who extend the hand like this and then you hold like this. No, it should be a proper handshake. And the duration should not be too long. It should not get into a political handshake where you hold both hands, like when Prime Minister meets the Prime Minister of another country, they shake hands for the 2 minutes, keep on shaking and people start clapping. No, that is not appropriate for a job interview. Just hold the hand, two movements, up and down, not sideways. Firmly stand up, two moves. not more than three anyway. So whole thing should be over in 2 to 3 seconds. It should not be over, it should not be overpowering. At the same time, it should not be like a dead fish handshake, what they say. As if you are holding a dead fish. There is no life in your hand. So you have to have a firm grip and you have to have hold it and shake it at least 2 or 3 times, at the same time looking into the eyes. This can create a very good impression straight away. Now, coupled with this handshake, you have to be dressed well. Now, dressing well has got different meanings for different locations. Now, if you are going to attend an interview in the Western world, in England or Germany, then you are expected to wear a formal suit and you will have a jacket and all those things because of the weather. Here again in India, the general tendency is to have a formal wear for job interviews, for managerial positions or engineering positions. But many firms of late have become a little bit lenient and they say, don't need a tie or a three-piece suit, but you can wear a jacket. So you can wear a full sleeve with preferably with cufflinks. If you are comfortable wearing a tie, you can wear a tie and no need of jacket. But if you wear a jacket, it becomes extra smart. And the color of the suit or the jacket that you wear should not be, certainly it should not be red or pink or brown. It should ideally be navy blue or dark gray. Normally, you don't wear light colored suit. You don't wear a white suit and go for an interview. You will look like the villain Ajit in a Hindi movie. You don't wear a light white colored suit for an interview or blazer for an interview. Always a blazer business suit is ideally dark trouser, light colored shirt, preferably white or white with pinstripes or thin checks, something like this, very light checks, okay, and a dark tie and a blazer on top. Make sure that you wear a belt. Many people, they don't like to wear belt, but you must wear a belt to complete the formal attire, okay? Belt is very important. And the shoes has to be formal shoes, either black or brown. If you're wearing a gray, a dark gray trouser and a gray blazer, you can even wear a brown shoe, but preferably black. And that too, not slip-ons. You must wear a shoe, Oxford shoe, where you are tying the lace. Contrary to what many people think, shoes and footwear are an extremely important part of your attire. People may wear a very expensive shirt and trousers. He may have a Mont Blanc pen in his pocket, but he may have a shoe which is past its expiry life. This is a strict no-no. Many people, especially us in India, we really don't understand the importance of good shoes. Okay, it's very, very important. And not only good shoe, but polished well. You don't wear a Nike for an interview, unless the interview itself is for a gymnasium trainer or a restaurant manager or a sports facility manager, then you can wear that type of dress. But if you're going into an interview where you are appearing for a position which is a responsible position, an engineering position, or a management position, then you must have these things on your list and make sure that you coordinate the colors. You don't wear a red shirt with a white tie like what you find Jayan wearing in a movie or M. N. Nambiar wearing in a Tamil movie. That is not a strict no-no. You have to look, you have to look professional. You have to look sober, and you have to look well groomed. These days, a lot of people sport beards and mustaches. If you're having a beard, make sure it's trimmed and neat. Not like Sadhguru. You don't go into a meeting like Sadhguru with a huge beard. It is possible in the Western world to have these type of attires with big tattoos and so on. But here, when you're appearing for an interview, I would recommend that if you have a tattoo, cover it. Once you get the job, you can expose it because it might convey a wrong impression. Not that I am against tattoos, but I'm telling you about convention, etiquette and norms. Now, this is for the boys. Now, when it comes to girls, well, again, multinational firms insist on business wear. Now, I don't know about this in India because I've not worked here much. When I worked in Calcutta, in McNeil & Mager, a business suit was a must those days. All the secretaries used to wear a Western outfit. They were not allowed to come in saris or salwar kameez. This was in 1977-78 period. So it was also a British-owned company. But nowadays, I see in Technopark, most of the girls are wearing Indian dresses. It is very much allowed. But if you're wearing a sari or a salwar kameez, you can always wear a small jacket on top. It might look more elegant. But if you're wearing a Western suit, well, make sure that the skirt is just at the knees, not too short. You don't go into an interview like Jennifer Aniston does in some movies. You're not going to a nightclub or a pub. You're going for an interview and you have to look smart, okay? Smart casual. And when it comes to ladies, pay particular importance to the nails. Don't go in with a luminous orange nail polish. Okay, there are these nail polishes are very common these days. You can do that once you get the job and when you start your work. But an interviewer, maybe not because they don't like the color, it is because they get distracted and the point of attention goes to the nail. Also, the color of the dress, you don't wear a very shocking color. You should not wear huge chunky jewelry. You know, that is okay when you're going for a dinner or when you're going for a social get-together or attending a wedding. But when you are attending a meeting, make sure your hair is kept well. Even if you don't want to tie it, it's kept well. It looks elegant. The nail polish and lipstick, not to be too loud. There are girls who wear dark brown or black lipstick. It's great. Great color to wear in a social situation, but not in a job interview. So this is very, very important. Now, having said that, the act of shaking hands applies to women also. But again, it depends on the organizational culture. When you walk into the room, if the interviewers are sitting behind a huge table and you cannot reach out to shake their hand, then don't bother. Usually when the interviewer comes, the interviewers also stand up when the candidate enters the room. If they are standing up, then it is easy to shake their hands. But if they are not getting up, then it probably means that they don't want to shake your hands. So you have to see the situation and take your seat. And again, when ladies sit, there are certain ways you have to keep your legs, keep your knees together at an angle. I hope you understand what I mean. Not the knees separate. The knees should be like this. So it should be very modest way of sitting, and sit with your arms on your thighs and look tall. Don't slouch. Look tall. Make a specific attempt to keep your spine straight and look at the interviews. This is the proper way to address the situation. If you do all this and make sure that you have a good color coordinated dress, you don't put too much of makeup. You can't put a green eye shadow and things like that. So be easy, be your natural look, okay? But touch up so that you look fresh. Don't go to a beauty parlor before coming for a job interview. It's not required. But at the same time, make sure that you present the best version of yourself to the interviewer. I hope I have conveyed that. Now, these days, I mentioned at the beginning, these days, some of the interviews are going to be on Zoom. Now, the Zoom interview is slightly different to the personal interview, in as much as you don't enter a room, you don't go in advance and talk to the receptionist. And when I said talk to the receptionist, the reason why I said this, in many companies, they also check with the receptionist. Four candidates are there. Who is more well-behaved? Sometimes the manager may have a CCTV camera and he may be watching the candidate as he comes in and how he conducts himself with the receptionist. Whether he is courteous, whether he is overpowering, okay, and whether he is talking to the other candidates. These are all small indicators. So I would say that the interview starts before it starts in many cases. If there are other candidates, always take the opportunity to introduce yourself and have a small talk. You don't have to give away everything about you, but you can say that I'm Krishna Kumar. I did engineering at CET. I passed out in 2021, and I'm here to attend this interview. So where are you from? What are you doing? This sort of small talk will help you in two ways. One is, if you are nervous, this type of small talk with the other candidates will ease up your vocal cords and you will be able to talk better. If the interviewer offers you a glass of water, even if you are not thirsty, please accept that glass of water. Take a sip, because that small sip of water will help you to set your mind at ease, and it also removes any dryness that may be there in the room because of your tension and because of seeing this very opulent office with hefty looking important guys trying to grill you. So this water will help you settle your mind. And in Zoom, you don't have that problem. But the most important thing in Zoom is download the application and get familiar with the controls. Now, if you have to show them any of your project work or testimonials that you would like them to see, then load it on a PowerPoint and get familiar with the controls on how to do it. Because sometimes you think you know how to do it and then it becomes a mess and you have lost time, and this will create one negative mark for you. Then most important thing in Zoom lighting, in Zoom calls, I spoke to a few of you because I was here half an hour early and I was telling them how the screen should be set up. The interviewer must not see any clutter in the room. Now, I understand that many people may not have the luxury of having an independent room with a clean background, but choose a room which is relatively clear. Like I am sitting in my bedroom because I have a clear wallpaper behind. So you should not see any used clothes or clothes lines behind you, hanging. You don't want to see things kept in the background. So the interviewer must be able to see the face of the candidate very clearly. Now, one is the background. The second is, you should never sit in front of a window in the daytime, because the glare from the window will adjust your camera aperture and your face will look dark. Now, if the only option is for you to sit against a window, make sure that the curtains are drawn and light is not coming in directly. Also, switch on a light in front. Now, if you see my image, I was checking with Ganga before the meeting whether my image is clear. And you should sit in such a way that the top of your hair to up to the chest should be seen. Not the interview should not be like this. This is a strict no-no. Also, you should not be too far away, and that, you know, you appear as if you are sitting at the end of the room. So it should be a medium distance, more or less passport photograph, or a little more, maybe up to the waist like this is okay. This is maximum. But this also will not show the facial expressions clearly. So I always prefer to have a format like this. This is the ideal distance. Use the headphones and test the mic with a friend to make sure that it is clear. Then the other thing, make sure that the internet where you are sitting, the Wi-Fi is powerful. You don't want to strain the interviewer asking you a second time, sorry, what did you say? Come again. Your voice was not clear. It is cracking. So that is, again, something negative. You are talking something seriously and you don't want external things to influence that dialogue. Make sure that you don't have any dogs or cats making any noise during the interview. If when you choose a room, make sure the room is away from the main road, and every 2 minutes an ambulance is going or a lorry is going and people are honking. So all this, you should be cautious when you are entering a Zoom interview. This is very, very important. So I've said that lighting, background should be plain. Test the audio for clarity. In Zoom interview, never log in too early. Two reasons. They may have shared a link with you, but this company may be interviewing 20 candidates on that day. Maybe the previous candidate is just finishing his call. And professional companies give a lot, 30 minutes for an interview. At about 25 minutes, the interviewer will say, look, your time is getting over. Can we wind up? Why do you need this job? It might look like a bolt from the blue, but you should be prepared with the answer. There are a set of standard questions which I'm sure the future trainers will be appraising you about, for which you should have ready answers. Don't say that I passed engineering in first class. I need a job because I need the salary for my life. So I want this job. This is a big negative. You have to read the objectives of the job, the job description. Try to match your attributes with that and give a very educated answer saying that, sir, you are looking for a web designer. Okay. And my project was in web designing. And I'm also working freelance with a company owned by my relative. And I've done a lot of projects in WebSida. I'm very, very familiar. And getting this job would really help me fulfill my objectives. At the same time, help me to reach the company's goals. So you are trying to say that your goals and the company's goals, you are trying to match. So these type of answers, every candidate should be ready with. Another question that they can ask you is, how do you see yourself 5 years from now? Now, if you sit quiet, the interviewer may get that feeling that you are not ambitious. This fellow does not have any idea what he is getting into. He has no ambition. He has no future. At the same time, don't say that in 5 years' time, I want to be the MD of this company, which means you want to take that interviewer's position. That is worse. So you again, you have to give a very, very educated answer saying that, look, sir, I'm sure I would, if I were asked this question, I would say, I'm sure that a company of your standing will give me adequate opportunity to grow. And with my marks and skills, I will be able to improve my knowledge and skills, which will be very useful for the company. In 5 years' time, I would like to see in as head of a department, or at least at a middle management level, where I can contribute significantly to the company and the company feels me as an asset. Something that like this you should say. So the interviewer will say, this guy is good. And all this is possible only if you do some research on the company in advance. You have to go to the company website. You have to ask your seniors working there, what sort of company is this? How is the owner? How is the work culture? All these recognizance you should do. Because, and somewhere in the interview, if you can also give a hint to the interviewer, I'm very happy to note, sir, that you have entered into the trading of software for Bitcoins. And this is one area which I'm really interested in. So I hope I get a chance to work in that area. Something like that. Then the interviewer will know that you have done your research and you are interested in the job. I've covered pretty much everything, but I've got a few slides on how your hand position should be. Now, this is a good position to hold in between the interview. While talking, you can say that, I feel that the company is, has got integrated facilities, and I will be part of a big team where I'll be able to perform, something like that. And never keep the hands closed. Never do like this. Never keep your hands in the pocket. These are some things that you should learn. See, as students, when you are in college, you don't follow all these things. We are all in a different world. But when you enter the corporate life, it's something different there. You have to also play by the rules, at least in the initial part of your career in the company. Okay? You can take the liberty of wearing jeans maybe on Saturdays. And some companies in the West, for example, if you are working in the US, it's allowed. But here, other than IT companies, no company allows you to wear jeans. When I was in production in Calcutta, they were not allowing jeans in the shop floor. You had to be dressed full sleeve tie, even if you were in production. This was the culture at that time, but things are changing and it may not be the same now. So this, but at least at the interview, bear in mind, it's better to be overdressed than underdressed. Okay? Very, very important. See, the left is holding, clasping is not. Up to this is okay. And this is a gesture not to permanently hold. While talking, you can say. No, certainly you don't want to look like the guy, who has parked his bike 1 kilometer away from the office and he was running, sweating, in Chennai heat, and your tie is halfway somewhere and you have got a writing pad and then your hair is disheveled. You look at the lady, how she is, proper belt, cream and white and beige trousers. This is good. Now, again, one point I forgot to mention. Don't take any things with you into an interview room. Don't have one laptop and then one writing pad on one hand, bottle of water in the other hand. No. All maximum allowed is one portfolio like this, files where you keep your CV. One piece. If you want to take your laptop back, fine. But don't hang it, hold it in your hand like a briefcase. Or keep it in the reception and just take your folder with you. This is very important because if you are holding it in the right hand and the interviewer extends his hand to shake hands, then your right hand is holding the briefcase. So you have to shift it to the left hand to shake hands. This you will lose time. So you have to be prepared. All these small moves, you have to rehearse and enter. Now, believe me, I may going into fine details, but all these will help you in the interview. That's why I'm going into it. These are points that you may overlook. Now, as AXA said at the beginning of the this training session, you will never get a second chance to make a first impression. So friends, make sure that you utilize the short time that you are getting to be face to face with the interviewer. And that's all I have to say. I wish all of you good luck in your interviews. And I'm here for some more time, as long as you want me. If there are any specific questions you'd like to ask on etiquette and first impressions, please feel free to say so. Over to you, AXA.
That was indeed a very practical, thoughtful, and resourceful session, sir. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
I now invite my friend Jason KLX to conduct the question answer session. Jason, over to you.
Good evening, everyone. We had a great training session by Mr. Krishna Kumar K. Thank you, sir. We know that after such a wonderful session, everyone would be eager to ask their doubts and questions. So friends, feel free to put your question in the chat box, or you may unmute yourself and ask your doubts.
I prefer if people can directly speak and also I can see them.
Sir, myself Arjun, I'm doing M.Tech from CET. So my question is whether it is necessary to wear a tie for an interview.
Very good and relevant question. Now, at the time when I was seeking a job, it was absolutely compulsory to wear a tie and a suit. These days, especially IT firms, they are not insisting on tie, and you can avoid the tie. But if you are not comfortable wearing a tie, make sure you wear a full sleeve shirt, again, as I told you, pinstripe or white or cream or light blue with a dark trouser. And if you have a good jacket, you can wear the jacket above it without the tie. That is very stylish. And it conveys a lot of, confidence when you wear the jacket. If you're okay with wearing a jacket, if you're uncomfortable, don't try it just for the interview. But make sure your shirt is fresh, not something that has reached its expiry date. Make sure that you did not wear it for the past 1 week and just took it from the clothesline and wearing it. No. See, you are trying to get a job. You have to be very, very serious, and you must look your very best while presenting yourself. Okay? It's not only important to wear a silk shirt for your wedding, it's also important to dress well for your job interview.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you for your response, sir. We have another question, sir. The question is, can you tell in specific about what all details should we include while telling the panel about ourselves?
Okay. Definitely, you should say one or two sentences about your family. Okay, just one or two, not in great detail. Like, if I were facing the interview, I would say that I come from a family based in Trivandrum. My father is a professor in the University of Kerala. I have two siblings, and I studied in St. Joseph's English School prior to joining the engineering college. And in the college, my specific areas of interest and my elective and project was, compressors or whatever you want to say. And that's all you need to say. And then you can say that I'm also very passionate about photography or writing poetry or I'm a runner, or whatever you want to say, or you're a swimmer, whatever, one or two sentences about the hobby, but never go into too much of detail about, and if they ask you, now you have to be careful here, because I have interviewed somebody for my company in Bombay, and the guy said that I'm a very keen photographer. So I said, oh great, what is the full form of an SLR camera? I'm using an SLR camera. What is the full form of an SLR camera? He didn't know. I said, look, if you are going to take a portrait of a person and you are using a 50 mm lens, what is the ideal f-stop you will use? He could not answer. So he just added that hobby for the sake of adding it. He was not a photographer. Or if at all he was a photographer, he was probably using a Click 3 camera and taking, you know, or a mobile phone and taking photos. He did not have an in-depth knowledge. Okay, so, or if you say, I am a runner, and you say, what is your time for a 5K? If you are a runner, you should be able to say for 5 kilometers, what is the time you take? Otherwise, you're not a runner. So when you say something about yourself, make sure that in case the interviewer is also interested in that subject, he may ask you a counter question. So say only the truth. Don't try to impress the panel by telling some things that are not true, because it may hit you back. But to answer your question, you can wear a tie if you want, but if you're uncomfortable, wear a jacket on top.
Yes, sir, I just want to add one more question. Sir, yes, is it okay to knock the door while you're entering into the interviewer office?
Well, if there is a secretary and if the door is closed, usually she will come and open the door for you if it is a high-powered panel that is interviewing you. They open the door, let you in, and they close. But how do you know that it is ready for you to enter? Somebody has to tell you, right? You don't know inside that room whether the panel is alone or another candidate is there. Or if you are sitting and one candidate has come out, then of course you can knock. But again, don't bang the door. Just 3 knocks or 2 knocks. And then they will say, come in. And when they say, come in, make sure that you walk tall, go straight to the panel. Yes, it is okay to knock. But my experience is most interviews, the secretary will, she will have a pad with all the names, and one by one, she will be asking the candidates to go. So you may not face the situation of having to knock. This is what I feel.
KK, I have not a question. I have a small difference of opinion. Okay. I would like to share.
Please.
Yeah. What I understood from when people say that, say about yourself, when a question is asked in an interview, say about yourself, what I have come across in various mediums is that, you try not to mention what is in your resume because it is already there, you know, and they have read what you are, and you put across more
aspects. Yeah, probably you're probably right. Yes. About your other character traits and other things that will enhance your CV. Okay. What you're passionate about and think, this is fun.
Anyway, we have a separate session on interviews, specifically on standard questions, which can be expected. So let us.
So I am not covering faces. Yeah. It's only in, I just mentioned that is all.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Pavin. Okay, why you're not on video, Pavin?
Okay, I am not in formal dress.
That's okay.
Okay, no problem.
Okay.
Tell me.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, my question is, sir, in online interviews, is it necessary to wear formal dress? Only top portion is seen.
Well, I have seen some YouTube videos which have gone awfully wrong. People wearing a lungi and a suit. I mean, see, it is an opportunity. You are trying to make a career. Why don't you take that extra, go the extra mile by wearing a formal trouser also, in case you have to get up or something, it becomes very embarrassing.
No, sir, I am not. It was not a funny thing.
It is important. I feel it's a serious occasion. It's a serious occasion. Somebody is taking the time to consider your candidature for a position in their company. And I feel it's very, very important to dress fully for that occasion. At least you are saved that trouble of taking a taxi or auto and going all the way to their office or traveling to their city. So the person is interviewing you in your own home. So, you know, wear a good shirt and pant, and no need to wear a tie and a suit if you are at home. But always better to be smart. Not t-shirt, not half sleeve, not, full sleeve. This is what I would expect the candidate to wear.
Yeah, that's why I was asking, can we wear half-sleeve shirts and all?
No. I wouldn't like that. I wouldn't like that. But okay, many companies, people like some nephews are working in the IT field. They are wearing collarless t-shirts to their office. Round neck t-shirts to their office with logos and all that. In their office, it is allowed.
Sir, is it okay to fold the shirt?
You mean sleeves?
Yeah, sleeves.
No, not in an interview. Not in an interview. This, I am talking about the formal old school style. Now, of late, especially in the IT industry, a lot of things have changed. If you go to Google, everybody is wearing sandals in USA. They don't even wear shoes. They don't have workstations. They are sitting on beanbags. So these are all offbeat type of work environments. But we are talking about an office environment where you are going in to sit in an office along with your colleagues, and you have a proper reporting system. You have a manager. So there, I think all these things matter, especially for the interview. You have to appear very professional and serious because you are here to convey the right impression about you.
Okay, sir. I had another question, but as it is said, there will be another session on interview, just for interviews. So, can I ask?
Yeah, Satish will answer.
Okay, sir. Is it okay to? Can we ask question to the interviewers, like more about the company, more about the job and all?
100%, your rating will go up if you ask questions. If you don't ask questions, the interviewer will think this fellow is not interested in this company. So better you, I would say that if you're not at the initial level, but if you are being interviewed for a managerial level, you should also see the balance sheet of the company and the profitability and the debt and the stocks. In fact, when I faced my interview for my second job, these are questions that I asked. I said, look, I have seen the balance sheet and it's not looking very healthy. And they said, okay, that is why we want to hire you. What do you plan to do? I said, these things are to be done. So I was able to do that because I did my research properly. So definitely you can ask questions, and that questions, when you ask also, Pavin, you have to imply that you have some knowledge of that company. For instance, you can ask, this company was traditionally serving the banking industry. Of late, you have brought out some products for the manufacturing industry also. Are you going to develop this area more than the banking sector? So this type of question will really impress the interviewer, because you have seen what the company was doing and which direction the company is going. And this will help them to form a good impression about you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you for the response, sir. So I have one question actually.
Go ahead.
Sir, in your career, were you able to be perfect always regarding first impressions and etiquettes?
No, not at all. But you always see, when I was entering my first job, there was no internet. There was no laptop. There was no desktop. So to prepare for an interview was not something that was somebody could teach me. I had to refer to that. We had that magazine, it is still available, Career Guidance Magazine, which you buy, where you get all these tips. So this is what we and of course, I had a lot of senior people in my family. So I asked them, see, what should I wear? And then I took guidance from them. And I had a suit, I had a tie, all those things. The first time I wore a suit was when I went for my first interview in Delhi.
So one more follow-up question. Imagine I have a very important interview coming up and I was really well prepared for the same, but something unfortunate happened. Should I drop the interview or should I just try to attend the same?
Well, two things can, either of the things you can do. Now, if when you say something unfortunate happened, if there is an unfortunate accident in the family and you have to go there, you can always call up the company and say, look, this is what happened and I have to be in the hospital because so-and-so is injured or so-and-so is unwell. Can I come at a different time or a different date? Maybe they are there only for the whole day. So if you interview at 10 o'clock, they say, okay, can you come in the evening at 3 o'clock? Then you should say yes. Because whatever is the emergency, you have to attend it in the available time and get back. Because this is also very important. You are seeking a job. So they may say, yes, we are here for a week. You can come back tomorrow. What time would suit you? Then it is okay. But you must call them and say that this is what has happened. Can I have another date? Or can I have a different time today? Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, we have one more question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, in order to make a good first impression, should I personally speak about myself or about the person who I'm talking to? What should I address first?
Well, it depends on what he is asking you to address. Now, you can't go into an interview room and start talking about yourself. It depends on the question. Like what Reju has pointed out, if they ask about, talk something about yourself, you can even say, look, as regards my schooling and education, I've already mentioned on my CV. But I would like to add to that, to say that I come from a family of educated people, of farmers or whatever. I grew up in this locality. I'm very passionate about nature. I love animals and I am an environment lover. You know, I am a member of the NSS where I believe in keeping the streets clean. So things like that you can talk. But the context has to be very clear. Now you can't, and you said they certainly can't talk about that company and the job that you are seeking because that nobody is asking you to speak. If they ask you a question, how do you fit into this job and what do you think you can do in our company? Then what you say is okay, you can talk. Or where do you see yourself after 5 years? Then you can talk all those things. Sadish, you were saying something.
Okay, yeah, I was trying to say something. Can you add a few more points about using these online platforms? Especially, you know, you mentioned it, I know that, but like, you know, about lighting.
Lighting. See here, that is why I wanted everybody to switch on the video. Now, if you see Aksa, Gauri, Ganga, all the backgrounds are clear. But others we can't see. I wanted to see a few more people just to guide them as to how this background should be set up. Now, in case of Murugesh Ramaya, not a member, he's probably one of the CETNs.
He's a resource person for all these sessions.
Now, if you see his position of the phone or laptop, it is pointing upwards and you can see the ceiling fan. Actually, the camera should be at eye level. See, my laptop is exactly at eye level. The camera is at eye level. So that is very important. Now, most of you, Satish, you are okay. But if you see, just now somebody had come online, it was very dark. Right? Who was it? Just went. Not for when somebody had just switched on the video. Can everybody switch on the video so that we can just look at some good and bad positioning? See, Pavin, if you see, there is a big bright light behind you, Pavin. So that is why when you move, suddenly your face is becoming dark. That should not be the case. The interviewer should be able to see you clearly. But nobody else is there. There are 107 people, but only less than 10 people have switched on the video. So it's okay. But the point, like you said, Satish, is make sure that the interviewer can see at least the top half.
Okay. Now Arjun Das has switched on his video. Do you have any comment on that?
Where is Arjun Das? I can't see Arjun Das.
Can you just say something?
Arjun Das, yes. Arjun Das, I am not happy at the background. Now, I don't know whether it is a virtual background or whether it is a real, you are sitting in an office or a store or something. Now, this is...
It is real, actually.
No, but this is a big distraction. Definitely, please don't use this room for an interview because the things that are in the background will distract the interviewer. So it should be, all the others have a plain background or a curtain or something. Otherwise, you can use a virtual background. You know these virtual backgrounds. Okay. Now, virtual backgrounds are good if you want to choose. But I will switch on a virtual background. This is a photograph that I have myself taken. I love this picture. But here, when I move, you know, there is a sort of lag. See? So if you are sitting still, then the virtual background is okay. But when you move, you know, parts of the body will be flickering. Now, Rahul has switched on his camera. There is some disturbance at the back and the angle is not correct, in my opinion. You must lift the camera and bring it to the eye level. Because, yeah, little more. Yeah, that is okay. And you use a different direction because at the back you can see some window and some door and all that. If it is better to sit in another direction, it is okay. Priya Thomas also is fine, but if you can move towards the left and just have the curtain alone, it will look much better if it is possible. Like I said, it is always not possible to have a clear background, but within your house, you choose a location where you can hide all the clutter. All our houses are cluttered. Now, it is not always possible to have a free area. But because it's a job interview, we should attempt to make it as comfortable to the interviewer as possible. This is the way I would like to put it. But lighting is very, very important. Now, I have put on two lights. One light is directly in front of me and one light is to the side. Now, I'm facing the light. That is why the face is clear. Now, AXA has got only one light, but the left side of your face is little bit dark. Here, little bit, left side. But it's okay. It's nothing bad. So, other than this, again, audio testing. Because
audio,
in our CET, CCC club meetings, many people, half the time, the audio is not clear. That is because they don't test it. If you use a headphone with a mic, it is very, very clear. It will be very clear. There should not be any problem. But this is a very important point that all the aspirants for online interviews should pay attention to, because we normally don't pay attention to these things, but it's very, very important because the interviewer may be a perfectionist sitting there and he may judge you, saying that, look, this person, this candidate, he does not have any common sense to find a good spot for the virtual interview. How will he do the job? So these impressions, once it is formed, it is not easy to change. Now, Arjun has chained it to the Golden Gate Bridge, which is a fantastic view.
So, is it okay?
Yeah, this is perfect. Perfect. But one more thing you can do is you can switch on a light in front so that your face is a little bit brighter if you want. But even otherwise, it's okay. Your face is not dark. But I think the light is on top.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Welcome, welcome. Abhinash Raghavan is perfect. But I would prefer Abhinash to bring the camera a little closer to you. Because there is a lot of background that can be seen. If you bring it a little closer.
Yeah, it's attached to the monitor. That's why.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
So that is it. I think that covers most of the important points with respect to first impression.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, one last question to wind up. Please ask.
Okay. So if by any chance you happen to go wrong in giving the first impression, is there any way to make up for it?
Well, very, very valid point. The only way to make it up is in answering the rest of the questions of the interview in a very professional and impressive way, which can change the interviewer's first impression a little bit. But you cannot completely undo. For example, I forgot to mention about ladies' shoes. Now, I observe people's dressing, and I find ladies within my family also, they wear the best of expensive churidars and saris. But when you look at the shoes, this is a shoe that should have been thrown out 6 months ago. You know, you must have a collection of shoes. You must have enough pairs of shoes that are color coordinated, because it makes a huge impression. Now, if the interviewer is a person who has an eye for detail, you are disqualified there.
Yes,
even we have I'm a very active member of a running club, and we have the most expensive shoe any runner will have is the running shoe, because the formal shoes are far cheaper than running shoes. Now, if you use a running shoe more than 1,500 kilometers, then you have to throw it, even if the sole is good. It's like the tire of a car. Even the tread may be there, but if after a certain kilometers, you have to change it, because the resilience of the rubber has gone. It may look okay. But there are people in our club who are running with the shoes that are 2 or 3 years old. It is almost on the point of coming out. But it will not only give a bad look, it will impact their knees. You will have a problem with your knee, because if the shoe is not good, it's the same case with the ladies' high heels. If the heels are not proper, you will have a back pain.
Okay, how many full marathon you have finished?
No full marathon at all, Satish. About 7 or 8 half marathons. Full marathon is on October 3rd.
It's your dream.
No, I will do. This is London virtual marathon we are doing, where about 7 or 8 people are doing. We don't have to go to London. We can do it in Trivandrum. Trivandrum we can do. That October we will be doing it. And there is no cutoff time. So this is the great thing. Otherwise, okay. It is a struggle.
Hello, sir.
Last question you said, Jasin.
Sir,
Anand is asking something.
Anand, please go ahead.
What should we take care about the hairstyles? Is there a problem with having long hair or facial hair like that?
See, personally, for me, I don't have a problem with long hair. But if you have a long hair, make sure that you comb it backwards and use a bow or even a ponytail. That is okay. You know, but it should be neat. I said not like Sadhguru's beard.
Okay, sir.
Keep it neat. Okay, long hair is okay. I think long hair is okay. We are not joining the military service. If you go for a military army interview, then they will disqualify you straight away. But for an engineering interview or a management interview, long hair is not a problem. Beard also is not a problem. But groom it well so that it looks neat. You know, it should be presentable. Don't look like a poet or a buddhijeevi. Don't look like a buddhijeevi when you go for an interview. Be
okay, sir. So some of our seniors are asked to clean shave before the interview from the CDP itself.
Sorry.
Some of our seniors were asked to clean shave themselves.
See, that's what I said. I personally don't have a problem, but when you are clean shaven, you are able to create a better impression to the interview board, because a unshaven face and untrimmed hair gives a casual attitude. That is what it is, because it conveys the impression that this fellow has no time to shave. He has no time to go and have a haircut. How can this fellow run a company? So that is the connection. Now, if you're very passionate about long hair, after getting the job, you can grow it again. Nobody is going to throw you out for growing hair, but you may lose the chance to get a job if the interviewer is against long hair. So why should you take a chance? That is my answer. You should not take a chance, in my opinion.
Okay, sir. Thanks.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please. Revati.
This is Revati Chandran. I'm doing my MBA. So I don't know if this question will be like a silly one, but anyways, I'll ask. So as you mentioned, like even if we are at the top of our game, if it is a really good interview panel, we will sweat for sure. So my question is, let's say I have a tissue or a handkerchief with me. And yeah. During the interview, I wipe off my sweat, let's say once or twice. Would it give a bad impression? Would it be like, oh my God, she's like out of...
Well, you can do it very discreetly without making it very obvious. That would be my advice.
Okay, sir.
Because when you go into the meeting room, before that, it's better to wipe your hands if you are sweating.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But usually it will be an air-conditioned room, so it will be quite comfortable once you face the panel. There should not be a problem. But the other thing, I don't know whether I mentioned, you have to always wear a smile. Because a smile, makes you acceptable to the panel straight away. When you have a smile, is not like beaming like this. It's light smiling. Pleasant face. Show a pleasant face. Especially a girl with a smile will be more acceptable to the panel.
Okay, thank you.
I think Jasin Alex will have to learn to laugh, it seems. Jasin?
Yes, sir.
Jasin.
You have to, see, you have a nice smile, man, but you are not smiling.
There was one CCC speech when the person was smiling throughout the speech. I don't remember his name. Everybody commented about him. It was very, I don't remember his name. Smile is a very, very good weapon to... to cool the interviewer. Okay, so sir. I think we had some interesting questions, and I think I have answered to the best of my ability.
Yes, sir. So if we don't have any further questions from the students,
yes,
I would like to carry on with Aksa. Aksa, may carry on, please.
Thank you, Justin. Sir, thank you so much for addressing the questions.
Very well, my pleasure.
Now I invite Gauri Nair for delivering the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Aksa. Hi, everyone. I hope you all found this session as enlightening as I did. My duty is to thank each of you for being a part of today's session. First of all, I would like to thank Krishna Kumar, sir, for handling such an informative session. We truly are grateful for the valuable time and priceless wisdom you have shared with us, sir. Next, I would like to thank our alumni and volunteers, without whose support this program would not have been possible. Finally, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all the students who are attending this program for making an effort to train themselves and for being such an active participant. I hope all of you will be a part of our upcoming training sessions too. Thank you.
Thank you, Gauri. What a splendid session we just had. Friends, if you missed out anything to note, please don't worry. The whole session is recorded and we'll post the link soon. Our next session is on the 7th of May 2020, that is tomorrow. Well, before winding up, I would like to say something. It's true that last few weeks have been tough for all of us, but none of us are alone in this battle. We are in this together. We will survive this horrible pandemic together. With that note, this is Aksa Mariam Sajan winding up. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy. Good night.
So, all the best to all the candidates to face who are likely to face campus interviews. Hope you will refresh on these tips before you face the board and wish you success.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Satish, thank you, sir.